Sometimes you want to give the sound of your voice a nudge a little bit to achieve the best tonal qualities. In this video, we'll show how to use equalizer audio effects in Wave Link to enhance your sound. An equalizer is a tool for adjusting the volume of specific frequencies in an audio signal. These can range from simple tools like low-pass or high-pass filters to graphic equalizers, or more advanced like parametric. Let's break those terms down. A high-pass or a low-pass filter are the most basic and primitive form of equalizers. A high-pass filter allows high frequencies through, and a low-pass filter allows low frequencies through. They can also be referred to by what they block from passing, as in a high-pass filter blocks low frequencies and is essentially a low-cut filter. Low-pass would be high-cut. If you grew up using a home stereo or boombox, you may be familiar with a graphic equalizer, with its sliding controls, which might number from as little as 5, all the way up to 30, sometimes more. Known as graphic, because the sliding controls themselves produce a graph representing the frequencies and how they're being adjusted. Graphic EQs often have a fixed set of frequencies they control. Another type are parametric equalizers, which differ by allowing you to decide which frequencies are controlled, and also how wide of an area you want the adjustment to apply, allowing for both very specific control and more general, gentle adjustments depending on your goals. Let's dive right in and look at some examples. Now you may be wondering why you would want to use an equalizer or EQ in the first place. Maybe you find that you're sounding muffled or thin. Let's use a basic graphical EQ to help with this. This is the 10-band graphic equalizer called LV60. Each band represents a different set of frequencies to control, listed above the slider. We'll begin by clicking on the slider marked as 250 and slowly bring it up to bring in more bass. You can hear how the quality of the sound changes. If we sounded a little bit boomy from speaking close to the microphone, we could also use this to drop lower frequencies, like so. However, before adding an EQ, be sure that you have your wave microphone positioned correctly and are speaking into it from a good distance. Speaking directly into your microphone from a distance of about 6 inches or 15 centimeters is a good starting point. For more information, we have an article over on help.elgato.com with some helpful diagrams for positioning. Another scenario, or use case, is for more precisely correcting audio. Certain frequencies can have a harshness to them, such as words containing the letter S. This is often referred to as sibilance. Using a parametric EQ, like Reaper EQ, you can pinpoint that frequency and pull it down to help hide it, like this. Reaper EQ has 4 bands active by default. Each band is a section of frequencies that can be adjusted. However, you can also add or remove bands on the bottom, though for most cases, you'll only need a handful. Let's say we sound a little bit muffled, and we want to add in some clarity to this. Let's start with band 4. Let's bring it up from 5 kHz to around 8 or 10, and begin raising the gain to increase the volume of these frequencies. Now keep in mind, you may only need 1 to 2 decibels to have the effect that you want. A light touch is really all that you need for the vast majority of adjustments that you're making. We can also do a high pass or low pass using Reaper EQ as well. Lastly, maybe just for something creative, using an EQ you can make yourself sound like you're in another room by cutting out all the high and mid frequencies. Or put on an old-timey accent and remove all the high and low frequencies, and it will sound like you're talking through an old radio in the 1930s. Maybe add a little bit of compression on top to sell it. Or, do whatever you want. So, anyway, these are the basics to get you familiar with adding EQ adjustments to your Wavelink channels. Don't forget that audio effects can be added to any channel in Wavelink. You may wish to use EQ on your game audio to remove some high-pitched sounds or calm down the rumble from the engine of a racing game, or bring some balance to a music track to help it blend into your other audio for a stream. If you haven't yet, check out our other audio effect explainer videos going over topics like compression, limiters, and noise reduction to help you dial in and supercharge your audio. You can find links to the effects shown and presets that you can import directly into Wavelink in the description. If you have any questions, leave a comment down below, and don't forget to like the video and subscribe to us on Elgato Workshop to learn how to get the most out of your Wave microphone and other Elgato products. Thanks for watching.